Dear students, today we are going to study eye cosmetic. There are different cosmetics available in the market which can be applied to the eyes or the nearby parts of the eyes. As we know that eye is the most attractive, most sensitive and delicate part of the body. Most of the expressions can be expressed by eyes only. There has been history that eye has been decorated or eye cosmetic has been used since ancient times. One of the common example is kajal, which has been applied to the eyes to beautify for the beautifying purpose of the eyes. There are different products available in the market, that is eyeshadow, eyeliner, eye mascara, eyebrow pencils, false eyelashes, cover makeup, eye makeup remover, etc. etc. We are going to study in detail one by one. As per the Schedule M2 requirement for the manufacturing of cosmetics, there are certain conditions are the requirements. First, location and surroundings, buildings, water supply, disposal of water, health, clothing and sanitary requirements of the staffs, medical services, working benches, adequate facilities, etc. Already the Schedule M has been studied and it is discussed in detail in previous parts of the chapters. There are different raw materials that are required to manufacture eye cosmetics. These requirements or these raw materials are pigments, fats and waxes, gums, preservatives, perfumes and some pearlescent ingredients. So we'll see one by one. Pigments, as per the Indian standard IS 4707, part 1, 2001, There are different pigments that can be used in eye cosmetics. Specifically, the black color, that is carbon black, charcoal black, iron oxide blacks, and blue color, ultramarine blue, Prussian blue, green color, chromium oxide, brown color, iron oxide, sienna shade, yellow color, iron oxide, arc shade, and in red color, carmine can be used. Color regulations in India. The regulations in India, it is governed by the Drug and Cosmetic Act 1940. In United States, there is 21 CFR. In European countries, the Cosmetic Directive of the European Union. As per the specification in India, the manufacturing of cosmetic with coal tar has been strictly prohibited, because coal tar colors that has ability to damage the eyes. Apart from that, there are certain specification on the presence of some metals and heavy metals. For example, the arsenic should be less than or equal to 2 ppm as arsenic trioxide. Then it should be less than 20 ppm of lead, calculated as lead. 100 ppm of heavy metals other than lead, calculated as total of respective metals. No use of coal tar dye or coal tar dye base for cosmetic to use around the eyes or on the eyebrow. No use of coal tar dye and coal tar dye base for cosmetic to use around eyes or on the eyebrows. As per the US regulations, that is 21 CFR, there has been certain ingredients or there are certain products which are banned or which are strictly prohibited applying to the eyes. The US FDA requires that most artificial coloring agents can be certified by FDA as a guarantee of their safety and purity as either DNC color or FDNC colors, that is Colors which can be used in drug and cosmetic are called as drug and cosmetic color, but these colors cannot be used in food products, whereas colors which are certified as food, drug and cosmetic, that is FDNC, can be used in food product, drug product and cosmetic products. So each and every color should have certain specification or certification from USFDA. As per the European color guide, European guidelines, the cosmetic directives of European Union identifies four cosmetic application areas. These areas are: application area 1, coloring agents used in all cosmetic; area 2, coloring agents used in all cosmetics except those applied to the eyes, such as eye makeups and eye makeup remover; area 3, coloring agents usable in cosmetic not intended to come in contact with mucous membrane, means those cosmetics which comes in contact with mucous membrane will come in area 3. Area 4, coloring agents usable in cosmetic that are come in contact with skin or open skin. There are different types of colors, and water soluble colorants, cream, soap, toothpaste, bath preparations, means shampoo, shower bath, foam bath, all these are water soluble colorants. Then pigment dispersed in bulk masses like toothpaste, face makeup, powder, lipstick, soap. Water soluble colors, that is oil and soaps. Color legs, means used in lipsticks and eye makeup. Second ingredient, fats and waxes. So generally we can use different fatty materials or waxy materials in order to prepare the eyeshadows or mascaras. Not mascaras, eyeshadow or eyebrow pencils. So first ingredient is petrolatum, which is having melting point of 43 degrees Celsius. It can be used as a base. Then we can use lanolin, melting point in the range of 38 to 40 degrees Celsius. Generally it melts at body temperature. Used in eyeshadow, mascara, for lubricating and for adhering qualities. Then kerosene, melting point 68 degrees Celsius, and this ingredient is having higher melting point, which is steepen preparation without making too brittle or hard. Carnauba wax, melting point is near about 85 degrees Celsius. It forms water repellent films and gives luster to the dried application. Specifically, the Carnauba wax can be used in lipsticks, which gives some structural rigidity to lipsticks. Then beeswax can be used and having melting point near about 64 degrees Celsius, which is used to harden the preparation. It gives structural stiffness to the preparation, but it will not make hard preparation. Used in the product and to be molded, for example, cake mascaras. Stearic acid, melting point 55 degrees Celsius. Propylene glycol, it can be also used as humectant, which prevent dryness of the product into the container. Useful in eyeshadows and also good lubricating properties. Then various gumming agents or gummy agents can be used, like tragacan, used as a thickening agent. Then various cellulose derivatives like methyl cellulose can be used. We cannot use in all type of eye cosmetic products preservatives. Preservatives are not used in all type of cosmetic products. Choice is from class alkyl p hydroxybenzoate. Methyl and propyl paraben can be used as preservatives. So why preservatives are required? Obviously, we are going to use different types of oils, we are going to use different types of gums. So there are chances of microbial contamination. In order to prevent this microbial contamination, different preservatives are required. Perfumes can be used but it may cause some irritations within selected areas. That's why the most of the perfume preparations or perfume product, perfume based product has certain tagline that not to be applied near to the eyes. Then some certain pearlescent agents or glittering agents can be used, which gives some glow effect or glowing effect to the eyes. So it increases more attractiveness of the eyes to achieve the lustrous and shiny or pearly look. Then aluminium, bronze powders or silver or golden powders can be used in order to give more attractive effect. Then guanine, bismuth oxychloride, calcium carbonate, mica and timica can be used in order to give some lustrous or shiny effect. Then first eye cosmetics, that is eyeshadow, we are going to study in next part of the lecture.